In the Great Thousand World, individuals are chosen by the Mirror of Judgment to participate in several trials to earn admission into one of the five great academies. Along the spiritual road, a fighter called Chen meets a girl called Lai. The two have had a love-hate relationship throughout the trial, and despite fighting, it is clear the two have feelings for each other. They are attacked by several assailants, and when Chen is captured, he awakens an extremely powerful burst of power, causing him to be nicknamed the Blood Calamity. He kills all the attackers but is disqualified and forced to return home in disgrace. He promises Lai to meet her again one day at the Five Academies. Months pass since Chen's disgraceful disqualification. His father, called Feng, receives reports that the Nine Nether Bird, a creature of great power, was recently spotted. He instructs his retainer to keep a close eye on it. Meanwhile, the new ruler of the Liu territory, called Kington, gives his son, called Mubai, a powerful crystal for the upcoming heaven exam, another way to enter one of the five academies. A fighter called Ling wins his match, but being overweight causes him to be jeered as Lard Ling by his peers. Kington taunts Feng about Chen's whereabouts, and he laments that his hard-headed son is likely off doing his own thing. Mubai's brother, called Yang, appears to watch the exam. Mubai brutally beats and embarrasses Kington, but before he can deal a foul blow, Chen appears and deflects his attack. Chen's appearance draws derisive cries, calling him an embarrassment for being disqualified. Mubai challenges him to a battle and agrees to give up his place if Chen wins. Mubai initially has the upper hand attacking from range, but the nimble Chen narrowly avoids being knocked out of the ring. Mubai decides to use a spiritual pulse attack, which is effortlessly deflected by Chen's great pagoda foundation. Mubai is defeated, but refusing to be humiliated, he activates the crystal from earlier. Chen disarms him, however the crystal shows signs of exploding. Yang manages to stabilize it and gifts it to Chen as an apology for his brother's actions. The arbiter declares Chen the winner, accepting him and try into the heaven trial alongside Kington and Ling. Chen hopes to see Lai again. On the other hand, Lai fights a last stand against the Fiend Blood Tribe, who have overrun her territory. The leader of the Blood Slaughter Group, called Tu, inflicts a deadly poison on Lai. With no hope of victory, she destroys the transmission portal to trap them all there and hopes to see Chen in the next life. Unwilling to see his granddaughter die, Tianchen reconstructs the portal and pushes her through it. She finds herself in the Northern Realm, which just happens to be the home of Chen. A vision of Tianchen appears and instructs her to seek out the Nine Nether Bird in order to cure the toxins within her. Unbeknownst to Lai, Tu manages to sneak through. Tu stumbles upon the Liu territory's main house and finds the mustard bracelet hidden in one of the sanctums. Identifying it as one of his master's artifacts, he takes it with him. He meets stiff resistance from Liu family guards, even going toe-to-toe with one of the retainers. Kington is later informed of the theft and wonders what the Blood Slaughter is doing in their realm, warning Yang to be wary of Chen's potential for growth. One of Chen's friends, called Kaien, brings him roasted pork, which reminds him of Lai. She asks him to team up with her in the upcoming exam, and he agrees on the condition of receiving the Sanla Deadly Mark Scroll. She warns him that the power within the scroll is powerful enough to send other disciples to the hospital, but he insists on receiving its power to quickly power up. They trick the patrolman, and Chen manages to sneak inside the library, where he encounters Yang. With Chen unable to enter the library due to his low cultivation rank, Yang assists him in retrieving the scroll. However, Chen absent-mindedly undoes the seal, transporting him into the trial within. He fights off several giants but is quickly overwhelmed. However, he identifies one of the giants as the primary target, and against all odds he clears the trial. Yang assumes he is dead and turns to leave, but is shocked to find him still alive. A shaken Yang now understands his father's warning and perceives Chen as a serious threat. Meanwhile, Tu is cornered by the Liu guards, who are now more than prepared for his bug arts, and he is forced to flee for his life. The following day, the Chen forms his team, composed of Kaien, Ling, and Kington. They participate in a spiritual exercise in the Northern Realm, where they fight for survival in the wilderness. Mubai, Yang, and Ling sense that Chen is nearby. As a small prank, Ling lures them into a field where they are attacked by monstrous monkeys, and the two groups meet face to face. Meanwhile, Lai meets Tu once more alongside his Blood Slaughter group. When she refuses his offer to lead her to the Nether Bird, he attacks. While the Liu guards reorganize themselves, Lai once again refuses Tu's invitations to be his woman in exchange for the Nether Bird. Meanwhile, the monkeys assault Chen and Mubai's groups, but no matter how many they cut down, their numbers keep increasing. With their backs against the wall, Chen hatches a scheme to use the crystal he was given earlier to amplify his great pagoda, blasting a large area around him and wiping out the monkeys. To Mubai's frustration, Yang agrees to cooperate with Chen's team. Elsewhere, Lai's movements are stopped by Tu's spider beast, but she blasts her way through with a water blade and escapes. However, the Liu guards are notified of the attack. They manage to apprehend him and loose a volley of arrows, but Tu unleashes a burst of energy that knocks them all back. While harvesting fruit for themselves, Chen and Mubai's groups are attacked by a fire monkey king. Lin courageously jumps in, but he is simply knocked away. Chen and Yang stay behind and delay it while the others escape with the fruit. However, they realize too late that the monkey's target is the fruit. They chase after it, and Chen performs the Sanla deadly mark, which defeats it in one shot. Yang is once again convinced that Chen is far too dangerous to let live. The monkey regains consciousness and goes on a rampage against Chen, but he manages to push it over the cliff. Yang saves Chen just in time, while the monkey's attempt to latch onto his leg fails. In a scene reminiscent of The Lion King, Yang drops Chen to his death, fulfilling his father's plan of assassination. Chu encounters three candidates and kills them. Lai encounters Yang, and when she hears of Chen's supposed death, she refuses to believe him and jumps down the cliff. News of Chen's disappearance spreads throughout the camp, and many believe him to have died fighting the Monkey King. The practice trial is ended prematurely on account of the attacks, and Master Zai declares Mu Bai's team as the winner for the day. However, Chen arrives revealed to have miraculously survived his encounter with the Monkey King, and produces the power crystal he fought bitterly to obtain. He recounts that after he fell, he fortunately stumbled upon a dragon leopard den. He throws a rock inside to lure it out, but instead a baby scampers outside the cave. Luckily, its mother emerges to defend its young against the Fire Monkey King and easily kills it. Chen's team is declared the winner, but his celebration is short-lived when he hears of the blood slaughter attack. When he learns that Lai is nearby and heavily injured, he sets out to find her. Kaien, concerned for Chen, accompanies him in his search for Lai. Several months ago, Chen first spots Lai on the spiritual road fighting back the followers of a man named Chuan. When she succumbs to their superior numbers, Chen intervenes and saves her life, but she is cold and refuses to thank him nor acknowledge his assistance. Back in the present, Chen and Kaien encounter Tu, who is revealed to have killed the other five missing students. However, he is still injured and means to kill them and restore his health. When he learns that Chen and Lai have history together, he assumes Chen is the reason why Lai keeps rebuffing him. Tu viciously attacks Chen, but he is given a nasty shock when Chen's Sanla deadly mark manages to blast him away, despite the difference in their cultivation levels. Lai spies them from afar from a tree, finally seeing Chen after several months. Tu manages to get up and attempts to feed on Kaien, who refuses to leave Chen's side. An enraged Chen once again awakens his bloody calamity, experiencing a surge of strength that overwhelms even Tu. Kaien throws her body in front of Chen and manages to calm him down. Heavily injured and with the Liu hot on his trail, Tu concedes the mustard bracelet to Chen. As Yang, Mu Bai, and the Liu guards arrive, they surround and attempt to apprehend Tu. As a last resort, he summons a wave of zombies in an attempt to escape, but he is cut off by Yang, who demands the mustard bracelet back. Tu replies that it is already with Chen, and Yang is shocked to learn that it was Chen who beat Tu within an inch of his life. Yang confronts Chen regarding the bracelet, but he feigns ignorance. Zai and the other examiners arrive and tend to Chen's condition, and he acts as though he is injured. When Yang brings up the fact that Chen managed to damage Tu despite his lower cultivation level, suspicion falls on him, compounded by his earlier disqualification at Spiritual Road. Zai objects to his apprehension, and when Yang tries to inspect Chen's body for the bracelet, he finds nothing. The following day, it is revealed that Chen had hidden the bracelet with Kaien. Zai and the Liu family once again approach Chen and interrogate him regarding his fight with Tu, but he pretends to faint. Yang resolves to prevent him from escaping the Northern Realm. With help from his friends, Yang escapes the realm, but he encounters another assailant as it suddenly rains, and he identifies it as a spiritual rain diagram. Chen reveals his attacker, a woman named Zong, who once again disappears into the mist. Realizing he is trapped, he tries to find a way out but gets distracted by a mirror image of Lai, who hugs him from behind and reaches inside his shirt for the mustard bracelet, and he fails to realize it is an illusion. The true Lai, on the outside, attempts to break in. Chen finally realizes the deception and he turns on Zong. But to her surprise, his great pagoda art manages to penetrate her rain barrier, allowing Lai to enter as well. Zong's water sword fails to penetrate his barrier, but his power eventually gives out. The real Lai rescues him just in time, but their fateful reunion is cut short when the assassin demands he return the mustard bracelet. Lai throws him into the air as a distraction, allowing her to undo the rain barrier. However, they are now surrounded by several Liu agents. They manage to fend them off, and they are reinforced by Zhu and several soldiers. Recognizing the battle has shifted in their favor, Zong retreats. Chen brings Lai back to the Mu family estate, where his father compliments him on getting a girlfriend. He then presents his father with the mustard bracelet, and he is shocked to find that the Nine Nether Bird dwells within it. He orders an attack on the Black Swamp within Liu territory to commence in 3 days. At the same time, as Yang informs his father regarding the bracelet's whereabouts, now aware that their plan of reconstruction the transmission gate has been revealed, he orders his own troops to move to the Black Swamp. Kingshan brings Yang to a hidden sanctum, where they meet his father, the former Lord Jingshan, dwelling within a massive tree. Although Jingshan pays no mind to Chen, he is concerned when he learns of his apparent victory over Tu. Feng caresses a small statuette of his late wife and expresses his misgivings about the operation in the Black Swamp. Meanwhile, Chen visits Lai in her room, but she acts cold and aloof. He reminds her of how much he's missed her since they parted in the spiritual road, and she becomes much more subdued. He leans into her, but Kaiyan interrupts them bearing grave news. Zai and the academy officials are on their way to arrest Chen. Kaiyan and Ling warn him to leave at once. Zai, having concluded from his investigations that Chen conspired with Tu and the bloody slaughter, barge into the Mu estate to arrest Chen. Zhu and a detachment of guards stand in their way, refusing to give up their master. They each summon their own mystical beasts, but the soldiers remark that Zhu's has supremacy over Zai's. In a brazen move, Chen appears to maintain his innocence, but Zai refuses to listen and insists he defend himself before the principal, but Zhu rushes to defend his young master. Mo arrives bearing instructions from the principal to set Chen free, on account of his previous merits outdoing his violations. He then invites Chen to talk, and asks him about his condition, warning him that the Sanlao deadly mark takes a dangerous toll on the body. He then wishes him good luck on the upcoming selection exams, as there is only one seed. He extends this blessing to Kaiyan, Ling, and Kinsheng, who was hiding in the bushes. Lai arrives and brings Chen with her to perform the spiritual diagram, to quickly raise his spiritual power. She demonstrates the technique to him, and leaves him to train on his own. She meets Kaiyan, who cedes Chen's training to him. Lai returns in an hour, and is shocked to find that Chen is now able to summon 5 deadly marks instead of 2. He emerges to find his friends waiting for him, and Ling hands him a sack of crystal fruit, and wish him luck in his trip to the Black Swamp. Meanwhile, Kingshan reports to his father that they have mobilized their forces and they are prepared to march on the Black Swamp. He asks why he has a fixation on Chen, but he snaps at him to know his place. He only asks that they secure the mustard bracelet, and with the power of the 9 Nether Bird, they will unite the entire Northern Realm under their power and make all the other clans submit. While the Mu forces begin to march, Lai confides with Chen about the poison in her veins, and how she expects to die within 3 years unless she can get her hands on the Nether Bird. She then plans to ascend to a saintess and rebuild her clan. Chen pledges his support to her, but she silently laments that if she does become a saintess, she must forfeit all her emotions and feelings. Against Chen's wishes, Kaiyan, Ling, and Kinsheng follow the Mu army through the portal. Using his bug scouts, Tu is also aware of the movements in the Black Swamp. As the Mu traverse the treacherous bogs of the swamp, they come under attack by giant snakes. Feng summons his phoenix beast to burn them to cinders, but an especially powerful snake blocks their path, whom Feng identifies as the legendary 9-eyed python. His firebird manages to take it out, but a swarm of bees threaten to wipe them out. Chen tells his father to go on while he holds them at bay. He unleashes a barrage of deadly marks, but their numbers continue to grow and they are forced to escape. The bees chase them all the way into a bog, where Chen and Lai are suddenly pulled underneath the muck. And this brings the anime to an end. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you enjoyed, and turn on the notification bell so you never miss out on another video. Until next time, take care.